I guess they came with their axes. Hello? And yet he was able to send his notes to Jesse. Jesse said, well, I got his notes. I said, well, if he don't get here, just give me his notes. I'll try to preach them. But I'm so glad he made it. I said this, I love my sons, all of my children, but I really love how God uses them, and I know today God's going to use him to bring us the word.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Why don't we give the Lord a hand clap of praise? Tell your neighbor and tell him he just keeps getting better. Don't tell somebody else. Jesus just keeps getting better. Like about four of you believe that. Does anybody believe that? The increase of his government and peace, there will be no end. Amen. Do you stand with me? Turn in your Bibles to the book of Matthew, chapter 13. And it is good to be here. I thought for a little bit I wasn't going to be able to come. It looks like the worst damage to the house. One of the firemen was inspecting the attic.
And
stepped through the drywall.
Pasaron por la pared.
So we have a nice imprint of his foot down in the hallway of our house. A few other minor things, but we're thankful for
that.
Amen. We're thankful for the hand of the Lord. And I'm just glad to be here. I do want to say thank you to all of you. Here the last couple of months when we celebrated our grand opening of our building.
En los últimos meses, mientras se celebrando nuestro apertura,
I think on that Saturday service we had more people from Living Hope DC.
Creo que en el sábado tuvimos más gente de Esperanza Viva DC
than we did even from Lexington Park.
Que de Lexington Park.
So thank you all for your support.
Entonces, gracias para tu apoyo.
And your continued prayers.
Y tus oraciones continuas.
Amen. That was the exciting weekend.
Esto fue el fin de semana emocionante.
And now we get to pay the bills.
Ahora podemos pagar las cuentas.
So keep us in your prayers.
Te mantiene nosotros
Amen.
En tus oraciones.
Amen. Matthew chapter 13.
Mateo capítulo 13.
And verses 18 through 23.
Versos 18 hasta 23.
All right. Hear ye therefore the parable of the sower. When anyone heareth the word of the kingdom and understandeth it not, then cometh the wicked one and catcheth away that which was sown in his heart. This is he which receives seed by the wayside. But he that received the seed into stony places, saying is he that heareth the word and immediately with joy receives it. But he has no root in himself, so it endures for a while, but when tribulation or persecution arises because of the word, by and by he is offended. He also that receives seed among the thorns is he that heareth the word, and the care of this world and the deceitfulness of riches choke the word, and he becometh unfruitful. But he that receiveth seed into the good ground is he that heareth the word, and understandeth it, which also beareth fruit, and bringeth forth some an hundredfold, some 60, and some 30.
Oíd pues vosotros la parábola del sembrador. Cuando alguno oye la palabra del reino y no la entiende, viene el malo y arrebata lo que fue sembrado en su corazón. Ese es el que fue sembrado junto al camino. Y el que fue sembrado al pedregales, ese es el que oye la palabra y al momento la recibe con gozo, pero no tiene raíz en sí, sino que es de corta duración, pues al venir la aflicción o la persecución por causa de la palabra luego tropieza. El que fue sembrado entre espinos, este es el que oye la palabra, pero el afán de este siglo y el engaño de las riquezas ahogan la palabra y se hace infructuosa. Mas el que fue sembrado en buena tierra, este es el que oye y entiende la palabra y da fruto y produce a ciento, a sesenta y a treinta por uno.
Amen. I want to preach for just a few minutes.
Quiero predicar para algunos minutos.
4 hours.
O a 10 horas.
All right.
Nervous laughter.
Risa nerviosa.
On this thought, dirt ain't cheap.
En el pensamiento que la piedra no es barato.
Tell your neighbor, dirt ain't cheap.
Mira que si dígale que la piedra no es barato.
Amen. The Lord bless you. I do want to give honor to my pastor. Your pastor. And the bishop of all of the Living Hope
Workers.
There's nobody like him.
No nadie.
He's a great man of faith. A visionary.
Con la visión.
I have friends, peers of mine.
Tengo compañeros míos.
In their late 30s and early 40s.
En sus 30s y 40s.
And they all ask me, how does your dad have more energy than we do?
Todos me preguntan, ¿cómo es que tu papá tiene más energía que de nosotros?
And it just seems like he's the Energizer Bunny.
Aparece como él es el Energizer Bunny.
Never runs out of energy and passion.
Sin terminar con su energía ni pasión.
And my mom as well, I love her.
Mi madre también.
If it weren't for her, there would be a him.
Amen.
Amen. I begin by looking at the idiom.
Yo comienzo con mirar las palabras.
Or the figurative phrase.
O la frase figurativa.
Dirt cheap.
Barato como la piedra.
Which is an expression that is used.
Lo cual es una expresión utilizado.
To declare something as being excessively inexpensive.
Para declarar algo como bien barato.
To declare that we have found an undeniable bargain.
Para declarar que hemos encontrado una venta bien buena.
Anybody ever bragged about finding a pair of shoes dirt cheap?
Alguien ha hablado acerca de encontrar unos zapatos bien baratos.
Probably the ladies brag about that more than
tal
the men
las damas más que los hombres.
But I have learned the hard way.
Pero yo aprendí de una manera difícil.
That the words dirt and cheap together.
Que las palabras barato y piedra juntos.
Are less of an idiom.
Son menos de unas palabras.
And more of an oxymoron.
Y más de un oxymoron.
As we were in the process of building the church,
mientras en el proceso de construir la iglesia,
and the excavators and the plows were out turning over the dirt,
y las máquinas se botean la piedra,
and pushing massive piles of dirt from one side of the property to the other,
empujando grande piedra de un lado al otro lado,
they found that there were issues with the quality of the dirt.
Se encontraron problemas con la calidad de la piedra.
Just by looking at the dirt, you would never know there were issues.
Solo por mirar la piedra no conocería que están problemas.
In fact, when they told me there was a problem, I drove over there.
De hecho, cuando me han dicho que tuvo problema, yo manejé por allí.
And I looked over the property.
Yo investigué la tierra.
And I said, I don't see what the problem is.
Las dije, no veo ningún problema.
But they had found what they call root mat.
Pero se encontraron algo que se llama root mat.
A network of roots.
Un raíz de raíces.
4 or 5 inches beneath the surface.
4 o 5 pulgadas bajo de el surface.
That extended pretty much everywhere that we were planning to build.
Lo que se extendió en cada área donde queríamos construir.
Beneath the surface where the parking lot would be.
Bajo del surface donde la alcarqueo estaría.
Beneath the surface where the foundation of the building would be laid.
Bajo de la tierra donde el edificio estaría.
So when the president of the general contracting company,
entonces, cuando el presidente de la compañía vino,
that was building our building,
lo cual estuvieron construyendo nuestro edificio,
called me to make me aware of the issue.
Me llamó para avisarme del problema.
He didn't say, Pastor, we've got a little problem.
No dije, Pastor, tenemos pequeña problemita.
But don't worry, it's no big deal.
Pero no te preocupes, no es un grande problema.
Because it's just dirt.
Porque es solamente piedra.
And dirt is cheap.
La piedra es barata.
In fact, he started the conversation very much the opposite.
De hecho, comenzó la conversación de lo opuesto.
He started the conversation by asking me,
comencé una conversación por preguntarme,
are you sitting down?
¿Estás sentado?
And if you're not sitting down,
Si no estás sentado,
I would advise that you find somewhere to sit down.
Te aviso de encontrar un sitio para sentarse.
And anytime somebody tells you that,
y cuando alguien te dice eso,
you know the bad news is on its way.
Sabes que las malas noticias están en camino.
The essence of the conversation,
la conversación,
was that over a few piles of dirt,
fue como sobre de algunos montones de la tierra,
there would be a work stoppage for about 6 weeks.
Se van a parar el trabajo para unas semanas.
And there's nothing more frustrating than when you're in a building process.
Y no está nada más frustrante que cuando estás en el proceso de construir.
And you've been watching progress take place.
Y has ido mirando el progreso.
And then for 6 weeks you drive by day after day.
Después de seis semanas tú pasas día por día.
And not one plow is moving.
Sin ver ninguna máquina trabajando.
Not one shovel full of dirt is being moved.
Ninguna piedra se está moviéndose.
And then he let me know that it would probably cost somewhere between $200,000 and $300,000.
Luego me ha dicho que va a costar entre 200 y 300 mil dólares.
To fix the issues of dirt.
Para corregir el problema de la piedra.
Thankfully, he was able to work some things out.
Él pudo trabajar algunas cosas.
And it only cost about $100,000.
Para costar solo 100,000.
But I've learned a lesson there.
Pero aprendí una lección aquí.
That dirt ain't cheap.
Que la piedra no es barata.
As we look at the parable of Matthew 13,
mientras que vemos la parábola de Mateo 13,
I would tell you in this parable,
te digo que es, en esta parábola,
it is the dirt that makes the difference.
Es la piedra que toma
yes,
la
sir.
Yes, amen.
Sir.
As Jesus begins to tell the story,
amen. Mientras que Jesús comienza la historia,
and then bring understanding of what the story means,
luego trae el entendimiento de lo que significa la historia,
he relays that there are four possible outcomes of this word of God.
Compartió que están cuatro varias maneras que puede terminar la historia.
And the only difference between those four different outcomes,
y la única diferencia entre las cuatro fines,
ranging from seed that is carried away by the fowl of the air,
entre de la semilla traído por las aves del aire,
to seed that brings forth 100-fold after its kind,
hasta la semilla que multiplica ciento veces de sí mismo,
and the only variable between the outcomes,
y la única diferencia entre,
is the condition of the dirt,
es la condición de la piedra.
In every one of them,
cada uno de ellos,
they share the same sower,
compartan el mismo sembrador,
the same seed,
mismo semilla,
in the same season,
la misma época,
but the only difference is
la
the soil.
Única diferencia es la piedra.
Amen.
Now most often when we read, teach, or preach,
y cuando nos leemos, predicamos, o enseñamos,
the Matthew chapter 13 parable of the sower,
la parábola de Mateo 13,
at least most often that I have either heard it preached or I've preached it myself,
a menos cuando yo estoy invitado para predicar,
we use it as a understanding of the climate for evangelism.
Lo utilizamos para entender el clima del evangelismo.
That there are some people more receptive to the word of God than others.
Que están personas más abiertos que los demás.
Some people that are in a place in life,
algunos en un sitio en la vida,
where they are more open to receive the word of God.
Más abierto para recibir la palabra de Dios.
We place ourselves as ambassadors of Christ.
Pongamos nuestros mismos como embajadores de Cristo.
As the sower.
Como el sembrador.
And then our neighbors, co-workers.
Y luego nuestros vecinos, compañeros de trabajo.
Unsafe family members.
Miembros de familiares no salvos.
They are the types of soil.
Son los tipos de la tierra.
Yet this afternoon I want to look at the parable of the sower and the seed.
Aún esta tarde yo quiero ver la parábola de la semilla. De la semilla.
Not so that we can determine the climate for evangelism,
no para determinar el clima para el evangelismo,
but rather for self-evaluation,
más para evaluar sí mismo,
so that we can determine, is my life prepared,
para determinar, es mi vida preparada,
for the word of God to produce a maximum harvest,
para la palabra de Dios a hacer una cosecha,
is the condition of the soil, the dirt, the heart in my life,
es la condición de la piedra, el corazón en mi vida,
is it prepared so that the word of God can bring forth fruit,
está preparado para que la palabra de Dios puede dar el fruto,
how can I tell,
como yo puedo entender,
and what can I do to ensure that it is?
Lo que yo puedo hacer para confirmar que sí está.
So for just a few minutes tonight,
para unos minutos esta noche,
I want to use the scripture.
Quiero utilizar la escritura.
To first of all, help us identify what kind of soil am I.
Para prim- veramente identificar qual tipo de piedra yo soy. Amen.
Tell your neighbor, I want to find out what kind of dirt I am.
Hey.
And then how can I correct?
Y luego, ¿cómo yo puedo corregir?
What needs to be corrected?
Lo que es necesario de corregir.
So that I can be fruitful in the kingdom of God.
Para que yo pueda dar fruto en el reino de Dios.
And living hope, isn't really that what matters?
Y esperanza es lo que más importa, ¿verdad?
Amen. Isn't really that what matters?
Amen.
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 I don't want to just be in the kingdom.
No quiero estar en el reino.
But I want to be fruitful in the kingdom.
Quiero estar fruto en el reino.
Jesus said that the tree that doesn't bring forth fruit.
Porque Jesús dijo que el árbol no que da fruto
is good for nothing.
Es bueno para nada.
It's going to be cut down and cast into the fire.
Cortado, echado en el fuego.
So let me first qualify.
Permítame primero calificar.
That as we look at this parable and talk about the soil.
Mientras que vemos esta parábola y hablamos acerca de la piedra.
The soil is speaking of the condition of our heart.
La piedra está hablando de la condición del corazón.
In Matthew 13 and 19.
En Mateo 13, 19.
Jesus speaking says of the sower casting seed into the ground.
Jesús hablando del sembrador echando la semilla en la tierra.
He said the wicked one comes.
Dijo, cuando lo malo viene,
and catches away that which was sown in his heart.
Y arrebata lo que fue sembrado en su corazón.
And so the four types of soil
entonces, cuatro tipos de piedra,
speak of four conditions of the heart.
Hablan de las cuatro, that's good, cuatro that's condiciones good. Del corazón.
The first type of dirt.
El primer tipo de la piedra,
or the first condition of the heart.
La primera condición del corazón,
Jesus identifies as wayside.
Jesús identifica
seed that fell by the wayside.
Semilla echado por al lado.
Amen. The first category is wayside dirt.
La primera categoría está la piedra en el al lado.
A wayside in biblical times,
hablando en los tiempos biblicales,
was simply a well-traveled path.
Fue sencillamente un camino bien viajado.
It might be what we would call a road or a street.
Lo que nos llamamos un camino o la carretera.
Obviously, it probably did not have blacktop in those days.
Sin el cemento encima en aquel día.
But it was a path that had been made compact.
Pero un camino con mucha gente.
By traffic passing over it.
Por el tráfico pasando.
The repetition of feet plodding upon it.
La repetición de los pies. Viajando.
And the hooves of animals passing over it.
Y los pies de los animales pasando.
Had turned that soil into a concrete-like surface.
Se convirtieron este camino como el cemento.
So if you can imagine right now a sower casting seed.
Entonces, si te puede imaginar ahora mismo un sembrador echando la semilla.
Onto a concrete-like surface.
En un surface como el cemento.
Much like rain bouncing off of a tin roof.
Mucho como la lluvia sobre el techo.
It makes a lot of noise, but doesn't make much of a difference.
Mucho ruido, pero no hace una diferencia.
As we would say, it's like water rolling off of a duck's back.
Como diremos, es como las aguas. Por la espalda de un pato.
And here's what I would tell you tonight, that wayside seed.
Aquí es lo que yo quiero decirte esta noche, es que la semilla es echada por un lado.
Seed that falls upon a hard heart.
La semilla lo que está echado por un corazón dura.
Has no chance of producing fruit.
No tiene ninguna chance de producir el fruto.
I didn't say little chance.
No dije poca chance.
Amen.
I didn't say minimal chance.
Amen.
No dije chance mínimo.
I said it has no chance.
Digo ninguna chance.
Right.
It hits that hard surface of a hardened heart.
Eso golpea el pie duro del corazón.
The Bible says it lays there.
La Biblia se dice que se acuesta allí.
And then comes the wicked one.
Luego viene lo malo.
And snatches away that which has been sown in the heart.
Y arrebata lo que fue sembrado en su corazón.
I'm going to identify from the scripture, how do I know that I am wayside?
Voy a identificar de acuerdo con la escritura como yo sé que yo soy de un lado.
Yes. Even though the Bible says every man is right in his own eyes.
¿Cuántos de ustedes saben que el hombre se dice cada hombre es justo en sus propios ojos?
So we would all tend to say, no, I'm good ground.
Todos diremos, soy buena tierra.
Pastor Jason, I'm good.
Yo soy bueno.
I'm ready to be fruitful. I'm in a good place.
Yo estoy listo dar fruto. Yo estoy en buen sitio.
I'm pray to be fruitful in the kingdom of God. But I think if we investigate the scripture, we might find out we're not as good as we think we are. Because the scripture says that the seed is cast there. But straight away the fowl of the air or the wicked one comes. And snatches it away. And wayside soil are those that God does something for them on Sunday. But by Monday you would never know that God did anything. Sunday they get a breakthrough. And by Monday they're bound again.
Atados.
They're atados.
Amen.
On Sunday, God speaks a word of peace in their life. But by Monday, you would never know that God spoke peace in their life. On Sunday, they get a breakthrough and they have joy. But by the time they get to the parking lot, somebody has offended them. Something has happened. And all the joy that God gave them has gone. They've got a hole in their joy
box.
Amen. God tells them through the preaching of the word. Don't worry, everything is going to be all right. But next Sunday they come back to church. And they need to hear that same word all over again. Because their heart is hardened. And they don't receive the seed of the word. Amen. I know people that God speaks peace to them on Sunday. And by the time Monday morning comes, they're twice as stressed as they were before God spoke peace. I'm sure that only happens in Lexington Park.
Amen.
No response from D.C., so I'm sure that doesn't happen
here.
There's that invisible barrier, that force field, right? That's over D.C. That doesn't happen to folks here. Amen. That God speaks the word of peace to our lives. And we just grab a hold of it. And the enemy never steals it away from us. But that's how you know that you are wayside soil. Like your joy is evaporating. It seems like your peace is dissipating. And I wonder tonight, can you understand the danger of being wayside soil? It's more dangerous than just forfeiting peace.
Es más peligroso de renunciar la paz.
And not holding on to joy.
Y no agarrarle el gozo.
But wayside soil they get tired of coming to church and having nothing to hang on to the
week.
They get tired of the devil stealing their peace and robbing them of joy. And so after a while, they just make up in their mind that I'm not even going to go to church anymore. It's some problem with the seed in my life, no doubt. It's got to be a problem with the sower. It's the preacher's fault. It's the church's fault. I'd be better off to stay home than go to church. But the real issue is not with the sower. And the issue is not with the seed, but the issue is the heart of man. I wish somebody tonight would
wake up.
I'm tired of people making my peace. I'm tired of the enemy stealing my joy. I'm tired of getting a breakthrough on Sunday. No retention.
ninguna retención.
If you're not retaining what God is doing in your life,
si tú no retienes lo que Dios está haciendo en tu vida,
you are wayside soil.
Eres la tierra de al lado.
Here's what the Bible says about wayside soil.
Aquí es lo que la Biblia se dice acerca de la tierra de al lado.
It says they hear the word.
Se dice que escuchan la palabra.
Everybody, if you hear my voice, raise your hand.
Si tú escuchas mi voz, pasa la mano.
They hear the word.
Escuchan la palabra.
But understand it not.
Pero no lo entienden.
Within the context of the passage.
Entre el contexto del pasaje.
The actual phrase is.
La frase actual es.
Understandeth it not.
Él no entiende.
Now,
no
here's what that passage is not saying.
Aquí es lo que el pasaje no está diciendo.
It's not saying that the wayside soil.
No está diciendo que la tierra de al lado.
Those that never retain what God is doing for them.
Aquellos que no retienen lo que Dios está haciendo para ellos.
That they lack comprehensive skills.
Que faltan las habilidades de entender.
It's not talking about you can decipher what I'm saying.
No está hablando de tú puedes entender lo que yo estoy diciendo.
And it makes sense to you.
Y tiene sentido para ti.
All right, remember, this is a heart condition we're talking about. And not a head condition.
Y no de la mente.
But the word understanding that is used there.
Pero la palabra entendimiento lo cual está utilizado aquí.
Is a Greek word, tsunami.
Es una griega tsunami.
Not to be confused with tsunami.
No estar confundido con tsunami.
The Greek word that is used there means to put together.
La griega aquí significa estar, poner junto.
Or to put facts together.
O poner los hechos juntos.
And it's not talking about you sitting there and understanding what the preacher is saying.
No está hablando de tú sentado ahí entendiendo lo que el predicador está diciendo.
And comprehending what it means.
Y entender lo que significa.
But it's talking like the act of a detective.
Pero está hablando de actuándose como un detectivo.
Who is taking facts from here.
Quien está tomando los hechos de aquí.
And a fact from over there.
Un hecho de allí.
And a little bit of evidence that they find over here.
Un poquito de evidencia encontrado por allí.
And some DNA that's been turned up from the crime scene over there.
En alguna manera lo fue traído de algún sitio por allí.
If they put those facts together,
si lo pongan los hechos juntos,
and it makes sense to them,
y tiene sentido para ellos.
They solve the case because they put the facts together.
Resuelvan el caso porque pongan los hechos.
But the wayside soil are those.
Tierra del lado están aquellos
that aren't willing to exert the energy,
que no están capaces de dar
or the effort to put the facts together.
De poner los hechos juntos.
Wow. Somebody this week.
Alguien esta semana.
You were listening to the radio.
Escuchando la radio.
And there was a song that came on.
Y tuvo una canción.
And God began to speak something to you.
Dios comienza a hablar a ti.
Earlier in this week, you were reading in your private devotions.
En la semana leyendo en tu
devoción. And you had a word from God that came alive. Y tuviste
la palabra de Dios que convirtió en vivo a ti.
And now tonight in this service.
Esta noche en este servicio.
Somebody has already said
alguien
something.
Ya está diciendo algo.
Or by the time I finish preaching, God is going to say something. And it's a little something over here. And a little something over there. But when we began to gather all of those things together and began to understand God is speaking to my life. Doesn't put the facts together.
No ponga los hechos juntos. Right.
They don't understand that God is working in every area of my life. The Old Testament word for understanding.
La palabra del Antiguo Testamento por entendimiento
means to pay attention.
Significa prestar atención.
To consider or examine.
De considerar o examinar.
I'm not talking about paying attention.
No estoy hablando de prestar la atención.
Amen. Just meaning you're watching my lips move.
Significando mirando los labios moviéndose.
And listen to what I have to say.
Escuchar lo que tengo que decir.
Amen. Again, I know this only happens in Lexington Park, but you're not texting while the preacher's
talking. Sí, yo sé que eso pasa en Lexington Park, donde estás enviando mensajes durante la iglesia.
I promise you, I didn't see you.
Si tú estás, no te veo. Yo te prometo ahora. No estoy llamando a nadie personalmente ahora.
Amen. That's not what I'm talking about by paying attention. Amen. But the word of God. It's more advanced than that. It's looking every time I come to church. I'm putting facts together. Every time I open my Bible. In the morning, my wife and I. We get up and have private devotion together. And I'm looking in that time of reading the scripture.
speaking something to my life.
Está hablando algo en mi vida.
Is there anybody that would testify?
¿Está alguien aquí que puede testificar?
That sometime during the week you were reading the scripture.
Si algún tiempo durante la semana leyendo las escrituras.
And then you turned on the radio and somebody on the radio was reading that.
Aprendes al radio y alguien
está hablando.
And then you
came to church on Sunday. And some of you are so hard-hearted.
Están bien
that you just like, oh, I guess that's just coincidence.
Oh, qué casualidad.
You don't understand that God is trying to tell you something.
Clean up. But neither one of them are going to produce any fruit. until I change the climate of the soil. Until I break up that hard ground and make it receptive to the word of God. What you need is not another word of the Lord. What we need is to obey the word we've already received from the Lord. Tell me what I want to hear. I'll listen to Brother Osteen on the radio. And if he don't tell me what I want to hear, there's always a word from Mr. Jakes. Or you pick your favorite flavor. It's a lot like what my children do with me and my wife. If they come and ask Valerie and she says no, they don't just sit back and say, well, I guess the answer is no. They say, no, I need another word from my parents. And so mom didn't tell me what I wanted to hear. So I'm going to go ask dad and see if he can tell me. What you need is not more words. What you need is not more seed. What you need is to obey the word that God has already given. The only way to deal with wayside soil. That hard-hearted soil.
Yes.
Is that it's got to be broken up.
Es que tiene que estar quebrantado.
Hosea 10 and 12 says, break up the fallow ground.
Josué 10 y 12 se dice, se rompe la
and if you've got a hardened heart,
si tú tienes tu corazón endurecido,
that you are not listening to and understanding the word of God. If you've been coming to church but not putting the pieces together, and preaching only has entertainment value to you, but not like changing value to you. The only thing that I can tell you tonight is you've got to come to the altar before believing, and you've got to fall upon the rock that is Christ Jesus. I wonder if anybody wanted to be quick on it. Come on, I'm tired of leaving and losing my joy. I'm tired of getting a breakthrough on Sunday, but people going down on Monday. I'm tired of being wayside soil. Lord, break up this hollow ground. Second type of dirt in the parable of stony ground.
La segunda tipo de piedra es.
Here's what the Bible says about stony ground.
Aquí es lo que la Biblia dice, dice en los pedregales.
It says it hears it.
Se dice que se escucha.
And receives it.
Oye y lo la recibe.
It goes through the process of putting the facts together.
Va por el proceso de juntar los hechos.
Like that detective coming to church, what is God speaking to
me?
They understand what God is speaking.
Lo que Dios está hablando.
And they receive it.
Y lo reciben.
But the Bible says immediately they receive.
Dice que inmediatamente lo reciben.
Those are the folks that get really excited by the word of God. And I believe all of us should get excited. I would rather be in a good church service than a ball game. I would certainly rather be in a good church service than a shopping ball game. Give me a hand for some of the brothers here. I get excited when God starts speaking to my life. I was excited Friday night when Brother Cornwell began to preach to exactly where I was living. I came to church that night needing the word from the Lord. And God spoke to the preacher to give me what I needed. Immediately I became excited. I received the word. Anybody ever been there where you needed God to speak to you? Church feeling like you were about to lose your mind. But then the pastor began to preach, and it was exactly what was happening. They're all a beautiful monster.
últimas cinco palabras
reveal the condition of the heart.
Revelan la condición del corazón.
Immediately there was excitement. Yeah, that's what I needed.
Al momento las recibí con gozo. Es lo que necesito.
I put the facts together and God is speaking to me and I receive it.
Junto los hechos juntos y yo lo recibo.
But the Bible says, but he has no root.
Pero la Biblia dice, pero no tiene raíz.
He has no root.
No tiene raíz.
Ask your neighbor, do you have roots?
You have root.
The stony ground is not like the wayside. The wayside is completely hardened toward the seed. The stony ground, there's some good soil there. But in mixed in with the good soil,
pero mezclado junto con lo bueno,
there's some hard places.
Están lugares endurecidos.
Mixed in with the receptivity of the Word of God,
junto con al recibir la palabra de Dios,
there's just some things that I'm not open to receiving
están
from the Lord.
Cosas que yo no estoy abierto a recibir al Señor.
God, you can have free reign over here.
No, yo no puedes reinar aquí.
But don't mess with this part over here.
Pero no, no me molesta en esta área.
You can deal with this stuff over
no,
here. Bless you, Lord. I'm all right with that. But when you start requiring things of me, that's when we've got a problem. And the stony ground is uncommitted soil.
Es la tierra no comprometido.
It's delighted but not devoted.
Es con gozo pero no comprometido.
Provoked but not persuaded.
Provocado pero no persuadido.
I'm stirred but I'm not steadfast.
Tirado pero no continuamente.
I'm committed with conditions.
Estoy comprometido con unas condiciones.
And the Bible says this about, listen, about the stony ground.
La Biblia dice eso acerca de los terregales.
It says they spring up quickly.
Se dice que se crece bien rápida.
And it looks great. Everything, wow, look at that. And they're just growing so
rapidly.
Yeah. Then it says when tribulation or persecution arises.
Pero se dice cuando la aflicción o la persecución viene.
And I just caught this part the other day. I'm sure I've heard it preached before, but it says when persecution arises because of the word.
Cuando la se dice, lo anoté hace días atrás, la persecución por causa de la palabra. No corazón del diablo.
Not because of your flesh.
No corazón de la carne.
Not because of this evil world we live in.
No corazón del mundo malo lo que
vivimos. But what the word of God is asking of you.
Pero cuando la palabra de Dios te está pidiendo.
Begins to cut a little bit too deep.
Comienza de llegar un poquito profundo.
When it starts to cause some pain in your life.
Comienza de causar un alguno.
When it starts to ask things of you, you're not ready to give.
Que no estás preparado de renunciar.
The Bible says straightway.
La Biblia te dice que está propiesa.
Oh Lord, I'm good as long as the word doesn't cost me anything.
Estoy bueno hablar porque la palabra no me cuesta nada.
It's all good as long as the preacher don't rub me the wrong way.
Todo es bueno a menos que el predicador no me molesta.
It's all good as long as the preacher doesn't cross my theology.
Todo es bueno tan largo como el predicador no confunde con mi
teología. But the stony ground has a problem.
Los pedregales tienen problemas.
When they connect their suffering.
Cuando conectan su dolor.
With the word.
Con la
and then the enemy begins to tell you, you had it better off in the world.
Y luego el enemigo te dice que tú
you had it
mejor sin la palabra.
You had it better off in Egypt.
Estuvo mejor en Egipto.
At least back in Egypt you had garlic and onions.
En Egipto tú tenías cebolla de comer.
Which I'm not sure why that would entice anyone to go back to Egypt.
Porque eso traería nadie a Egipto.
At least in Egypt you had a bed to lie your head
in. En Egipto tú teniste algunas cosas.
And many of us become offended by the word.
Nos ofende por la palabra.
And what God is asking
lo que Dios nos está pidiendo.
And the reason that we stumble because we are offended by the word.
La razón por la cual tropiecemos por razón de la palabra.
Is because we have no root.
Es porque no tenemos raíz.
We have no root.
No tenemos raíz.
It's condition.
Es una condición.
I'm good as long as it's in my favor.
Estoy bueno tan largo como está en mi favor.
Pastor, you keep preaching blessing and I'll keep saying amen.
Sigue predicando la bendición y yo digo amén.
Pastor, you keep talking about how God wants to bless my family,
pastor,
and I'll keep running the
aisles.
But when you start talking about what God is asking me and what God is requiring of me, I get offended by that and I shut down my worship and I silence my praise. Why? Because I have no root. The only remedy for the stony ground.
La única remedia para los pedregales.
Is you've got to dig down beneath the stones.
Es que tienes que pasar bajo de la piedra.
You've got to let that seed get some root in the soil.
Permitir la semilla tomar raíz en la tierra.
Let me tell you what the root means very practically.
Permítame compartir lo que la raíz significa.
It means I'm not going.
Significa que yo no me voy.
Amen. I'm not going.
Amen.
Job said it like this, though he slay me.
Amen. Job dijo que aunque
yet will I trust you. God, if you bring blessing into my life, or if you bring poverty into my life, I'm still going to serve you. I'm still going to ask the Lord. I'm still going to serve the Lord. I'm still
going to serve
the Lord. Ain't nothing to drive me away. Say that to get people home.
Digo la
esperanza. I'm not a green thumb. I don't know much about plants.
No sé mucho acerca de las manzanas.
But I did study enough.
Pero yo estudié
sound like I know a little bit.
Para soñar como yo sé un poquito.
But I read articles that let me know that you can plant seed in the ground that has rocks in it.
Leí periódicos de entender que sí se puede poner semilla en las piedras.
In fact, there are some plants that grow more quickly and more effectively when there are rocks in the ground because it increases the minerals.
De hecho, algunas matas crecen mejor en las piedras por razón de las químicas.
Now, if there's an agricultural person building today, you know better than what I just said. Talk to me afterwards.
Si está alguien bueno en la agricultura,
but here's what they say.
Porque yo hablo conmigo después del servicio. Aquí es lo que se dice.
They said you got to dig down under the rocks.
Se han dicho que tienes que ir más bajo de la tierra.
You got to dig down deep enough.
Tienes que ir suficiente profundo.
So that seed can plant root.
Para que la semilla pueda tomar raíz en la tierra.
And if those roots get into the good soil. Fruit will come out, but you gotta get deeper than the rocks. So I made up in my mind that I'm gonna dig deeper. I'm gonna get loose that river. Whatever what it costs me, I will serve the Lord.
That's it, right there.
It's time for somebody tonight to make up your mind. Because until you plant roots.
Porque hasta que tú pongas tus raíces,
it may not be today.
Tal vez no hoy día,
but there will come a Sunday.
Pero va a venir un domingo,
when the word will offend you.
Cuando la palabra te va a ofender.
But if you've got roots planted.
Pero si tú tienes raíces,
not even the word itself can drive you away.
La palabra
que
te puede.
I'm almost finished. Second time I said that. Soil number three.
La tierra número tres.
Is the seed that is sown among thorns.
La semilla sembrada entre las espinas.
And this soil seems to be a great improvement.
Esta tierra parece como está mejor.
Over the wayside and the stony ground.
Que el camino y los pedregales.
It's better than the wayside. The heart isn't hardened.
Mejor que el camino porque el corazón no está endurecido.
It receives the word.
Recibe la palabra.
It puts the facts together, examines,
examina,
and obeys what the word is asking.
Lo que la palabra está pidiendo.
It's better than the stony ground.
Está mejor que los pedregales.
It's committed and not with conditions.
Está comprometido sin una condición.
The thorn, those that grow among the thorns,
aquellos
they're not offended by the word.
No están ofendidos por la palabra.
They've got roots in the ground.
Tienen raíz en la tierra.
There is good healthy growth that begins to take place.
Está bueno crecimiento que toma lugar.
And even fruit that starts to be produced.
Aún fruto que está producido.
As is evidenced by verse 22.
Como evidencia en verso 22.
I noticed this in studying the scriptures.
Anoté mientras estudiando.
It says this about the seed planted in the stony ground soil.
Dice eso acerca de la semilla sembrada en la pedregales.
And he becometh unfruitful.
Y él hace infructuosa.
Letting us know that at one time,
avisándonos que en algún momento,
it has been fruitful.
Dio fruto.
The soil has known what it's like.
La tierra ha conocido cómo es.
To see the fruit of the Spirit being produced.
De ver el fruto del Espíritu producido.
It knows what it's
like to be fruitful in the kingdom of God.
¿Sabe cómo es estar fructuosa en
el I will tell you tonight that I would rather not ever know what the presence of God feels like.
Prefiero no saber cómo se siente la presencia de Dios.
Than to have known what the presence of God feels like.
Cómo se siente la presencia de Dios.
And no longer be able to feel it.
Y no más estar capaz de sentirlo.
I would rather never have been in an apostolic service. And felt the anointing of God. And to have been in the presence of God. And to have been used by God. And wake up one day and the anointing is gone over my life. I don't understand. People can sit in a church service and the presence of God is moving. And they sit there and don't believe me. And it doesn't bother them. There would be something in me that would say, I've got to get fruit from this back in my heart.
La Biblia se dice el mundo
and the deceitfulness of
riches, the deceitfulness of increase.
Y el engaño de las riquezas.
They just simply get busy with life.
Se están muy ocupados con la vida.
Well, Pastor, I'm not offended at the word. It's good between me and God. We're cool.
Bueno, entre Dios y yo estamos bien.
But I'll think nothing of missing church service to watch a ball game.
They'll
help me preach for just a minute right now. I'm talking to some of you right now that you used to be truthful, but now you've got to be busy with life, and God gets your leftovers, and He doesn't get your best because you've been deceived by increase. If I could just get more, if I could just get more, if I could just get a better job and a nicer car, if I could just live in a nicer house, then I'll be happy, and that is the deceitfulness of increase. If I could just get a new relationship, if I could just get a raise on my job, then I'll be happy. God, let me tell you where you'll be happy. It's in the presence of the Lord. And says, sow not among the thorns.
Y diga, siembra no entre los espinos.
You can break up the fallow ground.
Puedes quebrantar el camino.
You can dig deeper than the stones.
Puedes ir más profundo que la piedra.
The only remedy for thorny ground is you got to remove the thorns.
Pero la única remedia para los espinos
es a self-examination that's not very comfortable.
Es una examinación de sí mismo que no está muy confortable.
And not many have the courage to go there.
Y no muchos están suficientes valientes para ir de allí.
I'm not as fruitful as I once was.
No estoy igual de fruto que yo en que yo estuvo.
I'm a little more wrapped up in the cares of life than I used to.
Un poquito más preocupados con el afán del siglo, de este siglo.
Can I tell you, the American dream is not always compatible with the eternal dream.
Te digo que los sueños de los Estados Unidos no están siempre igual con los sueños de Dios.
I don't know what kind of ground you are.
No sé cuál tipo de tierra eres tú.
Some of you hard hearts.
Algunos endurecidos, corazones endurecidos.
Break through Sunday after Sunday.
Quebrantan domingo después de domingo.
Only to return Monday after Monday.
Solo regresar lunes después tras lunes.
Nothing.
Nada.
Nothing. Nothing remaining.
Nada queda.
Nothing being produced.
Nada producido.
Some stony ground.
Algunos se regalen.
Joyful with the blessing.
Gozo con la bendición.
But offended by the sacrifice.
Pero ofendido con el sacrificio.
Some thorny ground. Good people.
Algunos se regalen buenas personas.
You love God.
Amas a Dios.
You're not in opposition with the word.
Estás en una oposición con
you just, la your fruitfulness is being choked out by how busy you are.
No estás fruitosa por razón de estar
you, 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 you think that what you obtain in this world can replace what only eternity can grant you.
Que el dolor del mundo puede hacer lo que la eternidad te puede dar.
Then there is the good ground.
Está la buena tierra.
It simply says of the good ground, they hear the word.
Se dicen que de la buena tierra escuchan la palabra.
And they understand it.
Y lo entienden.
That's it. They just keep hearing.
Sigan oír.
Keep understanding.
Sigan
Sunday after Sunday, they come to church.
Domingo,
not to be entertained by the preacher. All right.
Por el
but to say, preacher, what is God speaking? Come on, I was listening to the radio the other day. And God spoke something to me. And now, I'm taking that in a fact. And I'm taking the word. I'm putting it all together. What it says about the good ground, some brought forth
30-fold,
some
60-fold,
and some 100-fold. And some have interpreted that to mean that Well, you got more talent than they do, so you're a hundredfold and they're
60-fold.
I don't think it's that at all. I think it's telling you there's no limit to how beautiful you can be. I think it's telling you that as much as you are, God will just keep blessing you. If you just keep coming and putting it all together, putting the facts together, you'll just keep producing for you. I want to ask us to come to this altar. I don't want you to stand up here and tell me what kind of soul you are. But there are some hard hearts. Some of you that are just about to give up because you're frustrated because what God does on Sunday doesn't ever make it to Monday. If it does, it definitely don't make it to Tuesday.
Sí, no va hasta el martes.
The only answer is you got to come and fall on the rock
Christ.
You got to come to this altar and raise your hands and say, God, break up the power of
God.
Lord, make this hard heart soft again. Lord, I want to be receptive to the word of God. I don't want to come to church to be entertained by the preaching. The Lord, I want to ask, what are you speaking to my life tonight? Come on, there's some stony ground here tonight. You're good people, you love God. You get excited by the blessings. God's asked some things of you that have offended you. You gotta dig deep tonight. It's not tears you need to shed, it's commitment you need to make. And I will serve the Lord. I'm gonna plant roots in this soil. I'm gonna stay in this church and let God plant me here. I'm gonna be like that tree planted by rivers of living water. And there are some of you here tonight. You just got so busy. Fooled by increase.
Engañado por la riqueza.
Deceived by increase.
Engañado por la riqueza.
And you're losing your fruitfulness. The only limit is you've got to reach in and grab those thorns you're removing. Because you can't sow among thorns. Come on, can we let the Holy Ghost move on now? All across this building, whatever kind of soil you want, whatever you need to do so that that seed can produce fruit, I'm asking you to do it. What would happen if tonight every one of us cultivated the soil so that we became good ground? This Sunday, God adds peace to your life. And next Sunday, God adds joy to your life. And the Sunday after that, God adds peace to your life. And fruitfulness just becomes abundant in your life. Can we pray one for another as the worship team leads? I see a prayer with somebody right now. Lord, I want to be good ground. Lord, I want to be soil that brings forth 30-fold, 60-fold, 100-fold.